We're back at another episode of Problem Solved. I'm Jake.
And I'm Carlton.
And today we're going to hit on the topic of internal positioning on a KEB drive. Let's do this. So Carlton, tell us, what is internal positioning?
Internal positioning can be described as using a standalone VFD to perform specific positioning profiles without the use of a PLC or motion controller.
So how is it used?
Inside every closed loop drive from KEB is the capability to program up to 32 indexable positions within the drive. And for each of those positions, you have the opportunity to customize a set speed and positioning modes, such as relative or absolute positioning within each of those indexes.
So what are some of the capabilities of this internal positioning?
Yeah, Jake, there are essentially three different modes that can be used with the 32 indexable positions. The first is considered a stop after each, which requires, before at the onset of a positioning move, requires a positioning start command from a digital input. And once that move is completed, a new positioning command input is required before moving to the next chronologically sequenced indexing position. The second mode is an auto index, which behaves very similar to the stop after each index, except requires only one positioning command at the onset of the sequence. Then the positioning module will automatically sequence through the 32-bit positions chronologically. The third positioning mode is considered a selectable indexing mode, which will allow you to select any of the 32 indexing positions in any order that you want. So you can move between position 4 and position 8, back to position 2, to position 23, to position 7, and move any order that you would like.
So what are some applications where this would be beneficial?
Yeah, Jake. So this internal positioning module would really be best suited for applications with single axis motion or sequential motion, such as a rotary wheel or a conveyor. Applications that require complex coordinated motion or multi-axis motion would really be best suited to be driven with a PLC or a motion controller.
So let's dive into it. Why don't you show us how it all works?
Oh yeah, let's do it. We're here with our S6 demo, and we're going to be diving into some programming with internal positioning on the S6 drive. For now, we're going to bypass the startup of the S6 just because we've done that in a previous problem solved video. So for now, we're going to dive right into the programming for the positioning module on the S6. So let's get to it. So now here in CombiVis, I've connected my drive and I've created this internal positioning parameter list that we're going to be using for this internal positioning module with the S6 drive. Inside this internal positioning parameter list, we see a set of parameters here that I have added before the start of this video. Taking a brief look at our parameter list, we have our read-write designator, our ID text, our parameter name, the offline value column, which contains the user-defined values that are stored inside the parameter list, our online value column, which are real-time values that are only displayed when connected to a KEB drive, and our comment section. We can write the offline value to the online value using the download list to device option that we will employ later in this video. The top four parameters here, you'll see these are RO for read-only, and these are ST parameters, so these are status parameters. We have the status word, brake control status, state machine display, and position actual value. So these are parameters that will just allow us to monitor the performance of the drive during the programming and then during the positioning run. Moving on from the status parameters, we are going to look at our control parameters here. We have our mode of operation, our position source, our brake control mode, and our control word internal for the drive. We were in velocity mode to do the startup of our S6, but we are going to be in profile positioning mode here for internal positioning. We have channel A set as our position source, so we can use the encoder feedback for positioning. We are going to change our brake control mode to application so that when the drive is enabled properly, the brake will automatically open and the brake will then close when the drive is disabled. We do not have to operate that through the control word. As of right now, we have an empty control word, but we'll describe how that will be manipulated here in our next set of parameters. Looking at the DI parameters, we have our CA input, CA mask, CB input, and CB mask. So these four input parameters are inputs and masks for the control word. So since we are not using a PLC in this case, we will actually use digital inputs, specifically digital input 1 and digital input 2 as shown here in the CA and CB inputs to control aspects of our control word to enable the drive for operation and positioning. So input 1 will switch the drive on, enable the voltage, and enable operation for the drive to move. Activating digital input 2 will serve as our positioning command, as that is operation-specific input 4. VL20 is our target velocity parameter. We are going to set that to 0 RPM so that when the drive is not actively positioning, it will hold at a zero speed position and not rotate continuously. Parameter PS38 positioning module is really important in this application, as this sets the positioning module for the drive. So just opening up this parameter, we can see the options we have for this positioning module. So for the positioning module, we will select index selection, which will allow us to utilize our 32 indexable positioning points. Our indexing mode is auto indexing mode, and we also have stop after each index if desired. For relative positioning, you can either choose to perform relative positioning based on the set position that you have or the actual position that is being measured at the encoder. For our sake, just for this test, we'll use the actual position. And you can also use roundtable positioning mode, but we will have that off since we won't be using roundtable positioning in this case. But that is an option for you if you so desire. So we'll exit out of the positioning module dialog box, and the parameters that we have discussed thus far in this parameter list represent the formation of the shell of the internal positioning module in the S6 drive. We have set our profile positioning mode. We have set our positioning source to the encoder. We have configured our control word to be controlled via digital input. We have set our positioning module for index selection. And now the only thing left to do is to program our actual indexing positions. So if we scroll down, the bottom half of this parameter list actually represents the programmed indexing positions. As you can see here, we in the comments section, I have indicated index 0 through index 5. So 0 through 5, that makes for 6 indexing positions. As we've stated previously in this video, there are up to 32 programmable indexing positions in the S6 drive, but just for this testing purpose, we are going to only use 6 positions just for simplicity's sake. So each of these indices are just copies of one another, but we can just kind of break apart what each of these entails in programming each of these indices. So looking at index 0, the first parameter we see is PS39 index position. The value of this index position may seem rather large and a little bit confusing to you at first. However, the S6 drive actually utilizes a 16-bit incremental resolution for every feedback device that is connected to the drive. What that means is for any feedback device connected to the drive, one revolution of that device corresponds to 65,536 increments inside the drive software. So this large value, if you divide that by 65,536, equates to 30 revolutions. So this is just moving 30 revolutions from its starting point or zero position. The second parameter, PS40, index speed, represents the speed at which this program position is obtained from the drive's previous position. PS41 index end speed represents the speed at which the drive will obtain at the end of the positioning move. We always want this set to zero so that when the drive reaches this position, the drive will reach a zero speed. The fourth parameter, PS42 next index, shows the parameter that is next up in the sequence of positioning. In the case of our testing, we are using the auto-indexing positioning mode. So once the index 0 position is obtained, the drive will automatically start to sequence to the index 1 position. The fifth parameter is PS43 indexing mode, and this is where you can select absolute versus relative positioning. For the case of our test and our 6 indices, we are going to select absolute positioning mode for all of them. For your setup, you can choose absolute or relative for any of your indices and use them interchangeably. Once you finalize the programming for your index zero, you can copy and then just gently tweak the programming for the following indices that you need for your positioning. And once you incorporate all of the indices that you need, you are ready to download the parameter list and start your positioning. So now that we have added all of our indices together with all of our programming, we're going to go up to the download function, download list to device. We will click yes. And that will download into the drive, and that is successful. And now we will test the positioning. Now that we have downloaded the internal positioning program into the S6 drive, we are ready to test with our servo motor here. So in order to test, we are going to enable our STO inputs. Based on our control mask, our input one will activate our control and release our brake. And now our motor is ready to run, and we are ready to initiate the programming sequence. So now that the control word is set and the brake is released, activating digital input 2 will initiate the auto index positioning command. So here we go. And that is an example of the auto indexing mode within the internal positioning module of the S6 drive. We can also demonstrate the stop after each index positioning mode within the internal positioning module of the S6. To do this, we will scroll up and modify our positioning module parameter inside the drive. We are going to change our index mode to stop after each index and then click OK. And we can see that this parameter was accepted in the drive. For this positioning mode, we are actually going to utilize the scope function of the CombiVis 6. This scope was created prior to the video and will allow us to monitor and record three parameters relevant to our positioning profile. We have ST33, position actual value, RU18, digital input state, which will show us when a positioning command is given, and PS47, active index, which shows us the active index position in the module. Now that we have the scope created, we are going to go start scope, and then we will begin our positioning. Now that we have reached index 5, we are going to go ahead and stop our scope, and this is the recorded data that we have obtained from the positioning. This blue line or curve that we see here represents the positions that were obtained from our indices. The magenta steps are the different index positions and the active index that was obtained, and these orange pulses represent the positioning commands that were given inside the drive. And just remember, from the program we created, we set the target velocity to be 0 RPM. So when the positioning is completed, as it is now, the drive will hold at 0 speed, awaiting a new command.
So thanks, Carlton, for taking us through the steps on internal positioning on a KEB drive. If you like this video, like and subscribe, follow us on social media, and we look forward to making more problem solve videos for you in the future. Have a great day.